Before starting installation, you need to prepare for some tools. Scratched vinyl, bubble label, digital tracking force gauge, and a scale. The first step of installation is to attach the VTA elevator to the tone arm. Loosen the nut and washer. On the side of the VTA elevator, there is a tone arm height adjustment screw. And turn it to show a small screw on the side. There are two screws, side and on the back. Loosen these two screws by using supplied hex wrench. Loosen these two small screws. So that you can install the arm through the hole. And this is a tone arm. On the side of the tone arm base shaft, there is a scale, and align the scale to the side screw of the VTA elevator, and roughly set the position, and screw it in. Fix the tone arm firmly to the VTA base. Attach the arm base to the tone arm. Insert the tone arm from the top of the arm base. And attach the washer and nut. Screw in the nut loosely. Attach the tone arm assembly on the arm post. On the top of the post, there is a small pin here. And two positioning indentations on the back of the arm board. Align these two points together and tighten the thumb screw. Remove the bearing protector. Let's adjust the tone arm angle. Check the tone arm travel range by manually operating tone arm from the first track to the last track. And also make sure that the arm lifter works within its travel range. And screw in the nut firmly by using supplied pins. Install the cartridge in the head shell. The distance between stylus tip to the illustrated connector ring should be precisely 50 mm. Make sure that the side of the cartridge is parallel to the side of the head shell. Install the counterweight and head shell. Before balancing the level of the tone arm, make sure that the tracking force dial is set to zero position. Remove the stylus protection cover and balance the level of tone arm by moving counterweight back and forth. When you could confirm that the tone arm is level, carefully tighten the counterweight adjustment screw. Apply tracking force. Turn the tracking force gauge to increase the tracking force. Value inscribed on the scale will be applied to the stylus tip. Up to 5 g of tracking force can be applied, even though there are steps at 0.25 g increments. The applied tracking force can also be set to values between steps. VTA, Vertical Tracking Angle Setting. Set the scratched vinyl on the platter and put the scale on the vinyl. Set the tone arm at the tracking position and make sure that the tone arm is perfectly parallel to the vinyl surface by using a scale as a guideline. If it is not parallel, use the tone arm height adjustment screw until you can get the correct height. Plug in the cable. Check the level of platter by using the bubble level and adjust the feet if needed. Adjust the anti-skating force. By sliding the mechanism from side to side, find the right position that the anti-skating mechanism works properly. The mechanism should start working at the beginning of the groove and then stop working at the end of the groove, without the bar falling to the opposite side. The canceller weight is attached to the scaled shaft. The scale is 1 g increments. The neck position is 1 g and the tip position is 5 g. Set the same value as the tracking force. If you don't want to use the anti-skating mechanism, simply raise the scaled shaft to an applied position. This is the final stage of the setup. Double-check the tracking force by using digital tracking force gauge. If the value is not the same as the value on the dial, fine-tune the dial until you get the correct value. If the tone arm lifter is too high or too low, carefully adjust the height. After completing all settings, check the space between the motor unit and the platter once again. If the space were too tight, move the motor backwards so that you can insert the spacer block smoothly.